Right, so the end of yesterday, I upgraded, or the end of this morning, I upgraded my equipment. I got this nifty little garbage service, so I don't have to spend as much time doing the garbage. I'm pretty much out of cash because I did a really risky gamble. So, yeah, we're just gonna see if I can make up the money that I'd lost through gambling. There we go. That's not so hard. Suppose he's gonna want food too. Ooh, it's raining. Greens and carrots. I wonder when my tip jar is going to get full. Actually, they could use that just by itself, as a measure of how well you're progressing. I know some foods do tip better than others, but it seems kind of strange that in order to progress, you have to both spend a lot of time, and you have to get a good deal in tips. I mean, I guess that makes it more challenging. But by all means, if you've aced this well enough to make tons of money through tips, why can't you just proceed in the game? Onions and peppers. Right. I'm lost count. Cheese, onions, and peppers. I pour you something. Mushrooms, greens, and carrots. This is not done yet. Okay, there we are. Alright. Small diet with ice. Medium diet with ice. What's up with this diet with ice thing? Ranch, cheese, bacon, and croutons. You know, they should be able to order two beers as an upgrade. How great would that be? Two beers should be an upgrade for one beer. Jumbo grape with ice. Also, why can't I just discard the thing that I prepared and say I'm gonna start over? That should totally be an option. Jumbo Cola with ice. I also like that background we've got. Though it'd be even better if that background were animated somehow. Small diet with ice. Rush hour. Small grape with ice. Small cola with ice. Medium grape and ice. cheese, greens, and carrots. So that's what rush hour is like, when you're the only person in the whole kitchen. It's just a bit chaotic. Two hours till closing. Also, how awesome is it that they'll tip me when I'm just serving them beer? I mean, where's the skill in beer serving? Plus, it's already a pretty damn expensive beer. And yet they tip anyway. I don't understand. Gonna get one more beer by... Nope. That's it. 44 perfect orders, one missed order, and two average. I got 12 in tips. That's not bad. I don't think. So I'm more than halfway there in terms of tips. I am halfway there in terms of days of operation or days of service. That all said, I'm gonna move the cursor off the screen. Where'd my cursor go? Let's get rid of that. There it is. Alright, pack that up. Make sure I don't stumble over this while I'm playing. Let's continue. Oh wait, how do I go back? I guess I don't, but I get to see here's all the food I served. Alright. Lasagna upgrade. Well, that's fancy. Purchase an air conditioning unit. Huh. Sherry Soto will be fighting back against robberies. In the meantime, report criminal activity. A notepad. Okay. Great. Robberies can occur randomly during the day and have a negative impact. You don't say. Is there a way a robbery could have a positive impact? Just let me know. You can practice robberies by choosing the practice chores. What of mine would they possibly want to steal? I've just got food. Should I try it out? Let's give it a go. Oh, people are tired of my food. What? I get a 5-day inspection and there's gonna be a robbery? How great's that gonna be? Parking. Please don't leave your dishes unwashed in the kitchen. Okay. So, let's practice the chores. Where is practice chores? Tutorials, practice chores. Select here. Oh, really? That's weird. Select eyes. How am I supposed to? I don't even get it. Select facial hair. He's wearing a mask for freaking goodness. I'm gonna try that again. So, I don't know. Sure, maybe, I don't really know. Select ears. Ah, he got away. Can't be serious. How can this be a thing? Am I supposed to identify him? Is that every robbery going to be like that? Oh, yeah, it's. I get it. Okay. He had spiked hair. I was not reading. Normal eyes. Long ears. Crooked nose. Small lips. And a mustache. Okay, I get it now. It's spiked hair, long ears. Wait, spiked hair, normalized, long ears, crooked nose, small lips, and a mustache. That's still crazy, though. But at least it's doable. Whoops. I've got 569 in money. I guess that's what he might be after, is money. The commercial toilet's not yet available. I'd totally get it if I could. Can't afford this. Enhanced security's not available. Could buy a deep fryer. I don't want to deep fry anything. Can I upgrade anything I've got? No, I can't afford it. It's just a case of really bad timing. Ooh, that's pricey. Lasagna. Okay. Check out all the boosters and detractors. Get good at making this, and who knows where you're going competition-wise. It's a slow cooker. It's got complexity. It's got fat. It's trashy. It's... Oh, but it's an upgradable item. Yeah, let's buy it. Can I? Can I try it out then? Pasta, sauce, cheese, and parmesan. And it takes forever to cook. But yeah, that's lasagna. Nice. So let's go to our active menu. Which things? Yeah, this needs to be rotated out in favor of this. Let's go back and start a new day. Begin. Jumbo Cola. With no ice and Flavor Blast. Man, you have to read that carefully. Sup, Inspector? How's it hanging? There goes the inspector. Jumbo tea with ice. Bacon, onions. Ranch cheese, mushrooms. Just greens and carrots. Water with ice. Okay, what did I miss? I missed something. If you're gonna just have vanilla ice cream, why would you go here to get it? Why not just, like, go to the store and buy vanilla ice cream? Is the vanilla that I've got that superior to just average vanilla? I just don't know. Small cola, no ice. That was pretty easy. I'm Likewise for you, just buying chocolate ice cream. I don't get it. Maybe there's novelty in going out to a place to buy it. Greens and carrots. Ranch, cheese, onions. Large grape with ice. Tea with ice, large water with ice, small tea with ice, ranch, greens, and carrots. Well, it could have gone better. Could have gone worse. Could have gone better. We'll take it. I've got to imagine that people playing this game tend not to be, I don't know, tend not to tilt as much as I internally tilt when something's missed. I know I'm saying everything's okay, but there's a lot of tilting that goes on when I mess up. I just want it to be perfect. Why can't things be perfect? Look, I missed two orders, and one of them I think was all because I missed a customer. The other one, I don't even know. I must have missed something else. But, like, no tips today. Tons of chores. Oh well. Fish upgrade available. That's cool. Oh, this! Finally! It's about damn time. Do not be alarmed! Your cooking skills are about to be challenged. Installing a new bet option. Here you will find a new random bet each day. Give you 3 tickets to start with. You can purchase more. I have no idea how I've got put into this cook bet thing. That seems rather complex. For advanced cooks only. Well, that's not me. Oh, really? Steam leaderboard weekly challenges. We'll save that one for later once I've actually got a career going. Dang, I'm gonna have a ton of buzz. So, in terms of simplifying my life, I would like to take this cola thing off the menu and replace it with this chicken thing. That's just going to make preparing the dishes a whole ton easier for me. So yeah, a lot of people are buzzing about promoting my little hole in the wall. Tick tock. Just greens and carrots. So, when's lunch hour? Also, what's up with these people who just come in and, like, first thing in the morning and order a beer? In what culture do people do that? Oh shit. It's rather kind that the game will tell you which dish is done and which one's not. Greens and carrots. Close enough. Dude, I made it with all the right ingredients. It might not look beautiful, but it's still the right food, so be happy. Cheese, onions, and peppers. Just know that sometime this week I'm gonna get robbed. I don't know when, but it's coming. Otherwise, the tutorial wouldn't have mentioned it. Oops. Imagine cheese. I might have taken on a bit more than I could chew there. I think I failed pretty badly. But time will tell. Ranch, cheese, bacon. I got an $8 tip. That almost makes up for all the things I messed up today. But not quite. Alright, how did I flub this? 3 failed, 4 average. So, I was expecting a lot worse. I actually did quite well, all things considered. So we're $84 out of 100 toward stuff. Ooh, there's a pasta upgrade. Can't do a 20. Oh, what? Of course not. No, I failed the 15 combo. There's no way I could do 20. Oh, nice. Okay, menu routes occurring. Still tastes good. Nice. Wait, I wanted to upgrade my dishes. So I don't have to serve the same damn thing every time. Salad. Six new recipe cards. Well, I can afford this, so let's do it. Yeah, I do understand that my menu suffers from menu rot, and that I've served the same things day in, day out. I don't really feel like shuffling things out, but if the game demands it, I guess I have to. Lasagna's kind of a staple of my place, but yeah, I can't get rid of that. We're gonna take on this next day even with, the risk of people not ordering the same thing every day. Lasagna is just too good of a dish for me to take off while I have other cooking dishes on there. Like, if I had a whole bunch of snacks that were easy and quick to prepare.
Oh.
Thousand Island dressing. Cheese. Mushrooms and tomatoes. Ranch. Greens and carrots. Oops, that's not the button. Onions, greens, and carrots. Not entirely correct. Not terrible, but... I mean, what do I know? Thousand Island, cheese, bacon, greens, and carrots. Cheese, onions, and peppers. Ranch and cheese. Thousand Island, cheese, onions, and peppers. One beer. One beer. Ranch cheese. Thousand Island cheese. Onions and peppers. Nice! So that was surprisingly far better than I expected. I did not expect to get through Rush Hour the way I got through it, so... You know, I could have taken the bet and had, like, half a chance of doing it, but, it's way too risky. You have to offer way better odds for me to take that kind of bet. Mushrooms and tomatoes. And cheese, everything on it. Let's pour the beer. Beer. cheese, onions and peppers. Thousand Island cheese, bacon, ranch cheese, mushrooms. Combo. That's insane. Well, that was close. That could have been... Well, I could have had my kitchen catch fire, you know? But if it did catch fire, at least maybe I get some insurance money. So, there's a silver lining to that cloud. There we go. Whew. So, if not for two average servings, I had a perfect day. That's crazy. I'm hungry. I'm thirsty. Okay, let's refill my water. Got my medium water, no ice, no flavor blast. Let's continue. Seven more days. Wait, make over 100 in tips. I've only made exactly 100, so that doesn't count. Wine upgrade available. For those of you who have the wine item, who just happen to be loaded, ooh, we get a commercial toilet. Nice. Notify tower tenants. You might get emails by next week offering you catering jobs. Okay. Giving all tenants an extra month to pay their rent due. Oh, a large boost in patience. Oh, really? Wow, that's special. Wait, I can't afford the commercial toilet. People are just gonna have to go outside. That's too bad. Alright, we've got menu rot. Is there a thing I can add to the menu for under 300 or under 400? I've been carefully avoiding fried foods, but the game is trying to push me toward doing that. Baked potatoes, can't afford it. Fish, nachos. Can't afford any of this. So, I guess this means, due to menu rot, I'm going to have to take some things off the menu. So we're just going to serve beer. That's it. Just kidding. We'll add cola back on the menu. It's going to eat me alive, but who cares? Here we go. Begin. Ranch, cheese, mushrooms, and tomatoes. Oh, that is nice that they have a... that all the customers will be really patient today. Ranch, cheese, bacon, and croutons. Also, it's funny when I put in the, put on the ingredients in a different order, and it just layers them as if I'd put them in the correct order. So where I like put the cheese and then I put the ranch on top, and it shows the ranch underneath the cheese. Small diet with ice. Let's go, 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 go! Come on. Here we go. Medium water with ice. $8 a beer. Medium grape with ice. Small cola, no ice. Mushrooms and tomatoes. Greens and carrots. Jumbo diet with ice. Two down? Who knows how many to go? I sure don't. Small grape with ice and flavor blast. So far, a perfect day. But you know, it's just gonna jinx it, but whatever. Just know the robber is going to come by today, on my perfect day, and ruin it all for me. That would be justice. Mushrooms and tomatoes. So far, so good. So far, so good. Hey, we hit 50. That's a new milestone. Perfect day achieved. Whew! Okay, that was close. But with a really simple menu, and with extremely patient customers, I was able to get a perfect day. I could have chosen an easier menu and probably achieved this a lot earlier, but, you know, we'll take it now. We'll take what we can get. Pizza upgrade. Enhanced security. Nice. Yeah, that's not supposed to happen very often. No missed chores to boot. Cool, I'll take it. Your food is really good. I was quite surprised when I was told it was so good, because quite frankly, I didn't think a tower restaurant would be that great. But it was. I'm proud of you all. Nice work. Alright, so what equipment do I get now? Or do I upgrade my menu? I think it'd be sensible to upgrade the menu. Either that or invest in some... a no weapons policy. So I got 1155. If I were to get two upgrades, I could get AC, and actually that would make customers more patient too. I could get a commercial toilet, and I could get not robbed as often, although robbing so far hasn't seemed to be a problem. Or I could upgrade some of my foods. Like I could get some fancy ice cream and stuff. There's so much I could do if I just had money. But I think long-term equipment will serve me much better. Let's upgrade our toilet, and, I don't know, I guess AC would help keep customers more patient. And let's put things back on the menu. I don't really care for doing the soda machine, it's really distracting. Instead, let's put the chicken back on, and the lasagna. Those tend to make money. Thousand Island, cheese, greens, and carrots. Hopefully it's not overly tender. Maybe I counted that correctly. I did. Ah, very good. Well, this game got a lot easier with the AC unit installed. Mushrooms, greens, and carrots. The Dry Deluxe. Okay. Yeah, this game just got a whole ton easier with that AC unit there. I admit, I don't have very much time to check what the names of the dishes are, but the ones that I am seeing seem to be pun-ish in nature. Could I get a second perfect day in a row? It sure looks possible. And this time it's with a little bit more of a challenging menu. And that, well, at least I got rid of that damn cola machine. That thing, it was pure evil. What's that? You want your pasta or your lasagna cooked? Tough break. Ooh, an $8 tip. That's crazy. Who gives an $8 tip for an $8 dish? Okay. Your investment into the Loch Ness Rocks Oil Island has been repaid in full, along with the promised 200% return. Okay. You won't find any of that weird random shenanigans when you make a bet with Crazy Dave. Yeah. Stay indoors for the duration of the alert. Like, how do they know it's gonna rain that badly? I'm Special Agent Johnson of the Immigration Protection Agency. I've been looking for Mr. Georgie, who immigrated to this country with counterfeit documents. He's believed to be in several illegal trades. Oh, really? Really, they're referencing Georgie. Like, the same Georgie dude. That's crazy. This isn't the same company that made that game, is it? Does anybody remember Georgie, or is it just me? That's hilarious. Where's all the fat guy models? I'm gonna go pursue the dream. Okay, go do that. Pursue your dreams. Don't let me stop you. I'm more concerned about upgrading my food than upgrading my security. So I get $2 additional each time I serve one of these. Whipped cream, oh my goodness. 6 new recipe cards. You know, that seems like a lot of work. Oh, I could upgrade my lasagna dish. Yeah, and I could practically, I mean, that's going to raise a lot of money. It's complex for sure, but we'll take a chance on it. Also, what's this? I still can't afford nachos on my menu. Is there anything for 300 that's worth buying? Nope. Checklist. So 5 more days of service and then we'll be able to upgrade or go up to level 2. The rat trap was like the easiest of the chores. I don't mind manually doing that for now. I'm sure at some point it'll be worth it. Oh shit. I'm surprised everybody's asking for the classic lasagna. Mushrooms and tomatoes, greens and carrots. People not know that I'm capable of serving them a far better lasagna for that same $12 they're paying? Something that actually contains meat? Are they just uninterested? Ah. Pasta sauce, meat, cheese, parmesan. Greens and carrots. Am I supposed to wash my hands after washing the dishes? Because, I mean, the health inspector is right there. Also, it's funny, when I go to clean the toilets, I do try to serve the toilet. You like hit the left trigger button. great to have patient customers. So nice to have patient customers. There we go. Gee, if somebody had tipped me one more dollar. Just been tipped $1 more, I'd have the number of the beast in my account. Yep, you saw me serve those dishes, and now I'm not going to clean them. Yeah, I forget if I gave a person, like, a frozen chicken or something, but they weren't happy about that. View the challenge in the extras menu. Click and start. Menu routes occurring. I passed my inspection. Hooray! Animal to avoid today. Cow. Yeah. Yeah, I'll definitely be taking that into account. Unless I won't. Is there anything I could buy for $699? There is not. Surprisingly enough. Is there anything here I could get for $699? Not exactly. Alright, well, we've got menu rot. Should we take on a catering event? Sure, why not? Burger and pizza party. You'll have to have purchased both the burger and the pizza foods for the event. Well, that's not happening anytime soon, then. I guess we're just gonna... Well, I could either modify my menu, take off my fantastically successful dishes, or just deal with the fact that I've got menu rot and make a ton of money anyway. All this food's making me hungry. Does anybody else get hungry playing or watching this game? Or is it just me? Also, what's with people showing up in the tower? Well, okay, I guess I am a one-star restaurant. So there's, like, no standard as to, like, how people are supposed to dress. Thousand Island, cheese, mushrooms, and tomatoes. Just greens and carrots, please. Ranch, greens, and carrots. Thousand Island, cheese, greens, and carrots. Oopsie daisy. I goofed that combo. My bad. A thousand flavors. What would it take for me to be able to afford to just put all the dishes onto my menu? French, cheese, bacon. French, cheese... I messed up. French, cheese, everything on it. Man, people really like that chicken dish. Or they just don't like the rest of my menu. I'm gonna wager it's that they just don't like the rest of my menu, and they can put up with, chicken. I'm also kind of surprised these people aren't horrified by the way I prepare the food. Just so barbarically smashing their food together. I must somehow be able to do it with some degree of finesse. Sup, dude? You arrived just in time. Oh, and you gave me $8 tip for staying late. Nice. Steak upgrade now available. I need a boyfriend. False alarm. Oh, it's not food poisoning, so it should be safe to use the bathroom. Okay. Don't know what that's about. $11.07. Still enough to upgrade, the ice cream. That's not the thing I want to upgrade. Is there anything, any equipment that's worth getting? Any food that's worth getting for 1100? There's the baked potato, which I can't afford. There's nachos. Ouch. There's all kinds of things I don't like about that. I guess I could upgrade my ice cream. Not that I really care to do so. Yeah, if I could only afford this, that'd be amazing. What's so good about this dish, though? VIP allure. To go. Oh. It's a simple food, though, and it's a healthy food. Whereas this, I mean... Well... Sopapira. Let's just try this out. What's all the benefits of this? No impact on dishes or rodents. Really easy to make. Okay, let's try it out. Dunk basket. One sopapilla, but no sugar. Okay, I get it. That's actually pretty simple to make, too. I would need a fryer to make it. Right? So, I guess I should get a fryer. Even though I don't like fried foods in general. Either I could get a stove. If I had a stove, I could consider... what? There's a soup dish here. Stove required to get a soup. Oh, but that's a mind melter. Let's try it out. See just how bad this is. Okay, chicken noodle. Chicken. Bowtie noodle. Bouillon cube, Celery. Hold for more ingredients. Wrong button. Bow tie noodles, bouillon coupes, seasoning, tomatoes, carrots, celery. Press right trigger to cut with a knife. Okay, I get it. Chicken, bow tie, bouillon, and celery. And then left to cook. It's one of the hardest foods to make in the game because it requires so many damn buttons. That does seem challenging. Didn't wash hands. You're right. Alright. Oh, I can't even afford the burger. That's too bad. Oh, for a perfect order. Well, let's try it out. I know I can't afford it, but I'm curious. What does a perfect burger look like? Three meat patties. One, two, three. Man, that was tough. That was, like, super tough. Okay, and cheese. Perfect. Then tell me what order to put things in. Oh, so it says two meat patties, and then after that's come around, then I have to actually put it together. Meat, lettuce, bacon, cheese, and tomatoes. Okay. BLT. Bacon, lettuce, tomatoes, and cheese. Meat and tomatoes only. That's not so bad. See, that's... I understand why that's a competition item. Yeah, nachos are kind of a mess for my entire restaurant. Baked potatoes, surprisingly, something I can't afford. What's so bad about it, I wonder? Menu rot, slow cooker, and creates trash. But yeah, if I could, I'd make baked potatoes, but I can't afford it. Also, if I could, I'd upgrade this chicken dish, because making just plain old chicken's kind of boring. I can't afford the upgrade, though. It costs $1,800. I mean, I could keep doing more and more work until I could finally... This practically doubles the amount of money I get on this. But yeah, I need more things that I can add on my menu, like the baked potato. Well, hopefully I don't get robbed. I know the game told me about this robber character. Are you serious? Whoever worked last shift, which is me, didn't clean up after their shift. Just greens and carrots, please. But yeah, that's totally on me for not cleaning up after a last shift. I'm getting all this crap to do in the morning. Free chocolate. Why do you go to a place and order chocolate ice cream? Well, a solution to being hungry is you just make some food, right? Or buy the game and focus on all the virtual food, because it's beautiful. Though, I can imagine this game being even more beautiful with some DLC. Can you imagine just like custom 3D artwork? Or being able to import your own sprites or whatever. There's all kinds of ways you can make this game look even more awesome. Beautiful thing about these slow dishes is that during rush hour, it occupies all the slots that the customers would occupy. So that makes it a lot easier to just do a good job serving everybody. Whoops, well, I goofed twice on that. Ranch, greens, and carrots. Sorry. People get really worked out or worked up when I put the wrong things in their food or even when I put them in the wrong order. You would think that for a dish like pasta, you wouldn't really strongly care what order the things were in, as long as the right ingredients are there. Thousand Island cheese, greens, and carrots. Again, why would you go to a place and order plain chocolate? It just befuddles me. You demand sushi. Hey, believe me, if I were able to serve it, if I had the fish, I would serve it. But I have no fish supplier at the moment, so there's only so much I can do. Believe it or not, that's eventually going to be a thing on my menu. It's just taking a while for me to acquire the money to get the things on the menu. Oops, that was the wrong thing. Sorry, I missed a step. Thousand Island cheese, onions, and peppers. Thousand Island bacon and croutons. Mushrooms, greens. Shit. There's gotta be some button I can use. There's gotta be a different way to map that. See, the serve button isn't the same as the start thing button. Cheese. Onions. Nice. I like how on the menu it's called edible chicken breast. It's like, yeah, it's nothing special. It's chicken, if you like chicken. Thousand Island, cheese, greens and carrots. Okay. Fumbled a bit that day. Not too concerned. Soup upgrade now available. You know, because they say soup is the most Oh, we get 6 slots on our menu now. Okay, it's gonna be raining. Menu rot's occurring. Cook, serve, delicious. Hey, I'd get cook, serve, delicious. That's me. Because that's my restaurant. But okay. I can afford to put baked potato on the menu. Which is good for rainy days. Let's buy it. And sure, why not? Let's practice it too. Cheese, sour cream. Wait, am I supposed to cook it? Nothing on it, please. Requires you to cook first before prepping. Select the potato to begin cooking. Oh, and then once it's cooked, then prep it. Got it. Sour cream, bacon, onions. Okay, got it. Crisis averted. All right. Should probably add that on the menu. Do I take the lasagna? Well, I've got menu rot. I don't care. It's just how my restaurant operates, is that it has staples that it's just never going to take off the menu. Just butter. Well, that's not so bad. Nothing on it. Ranch and cheese. Quiet rainy day. Cheese, sour cream, butter. And with that, I made it through rush hour. That one's a little bit trickier because you have to add meat in the middle of that rotation. You can't just spin the control pad. I do wonder when the thief's gonna arrive, though. Maybe he just doesn't bother small institutions like mine. You know, in hindsight, I probably should have added the baked potato to my menu a long, long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away. But, you know, I'll take what I can get. Cooking, is it? Cheese, sour cream, butter, chives, bacon, and onions. Thousand Island, cheese, mushrooms, and tomatoes. One beer. Cheese, greens and carrots, ranch cheese, bacon, croutons. I have too many things on my menu. It's causing me quite the headache trying to remember what are all the recipes that I've got. Do 44 perfect orders. One order where I slipped up. One more day, and then I'll be out of this category. Without making a single bad order. Yeah, no, that's just not gonna happen. That's completely nuts. Wait, with a single bad order? He's not saying every order has to be perfect, but he's just saying it can't have any bad orders. Ooh, that... I don't know. Actually, that gives me a motivation to take the Rodman items off my menu. We'll take the bet. It's going to ruin me, but whatever. Avoid the hedgehog. Avoid the chinchilla. Noted. Alright, let's take our active menu and take everything rotted off of it. Let's put the baked potato up here on the menu. I don't think it even matters where I put them, but this should be doable. If I want to make this extra simple, I just take salad off the menu. That's no fun. That's not a challenge. I'm going to try to make it through today without making a single bad order. Thousand Island, cheese, bacon, and croutons. Also, I want to know, like, if anybody can be served food they're allergic to. How incredible would that be? You accidentally serve them the wrong thing, they're allergic, and then they fall over. And it falls to you to call for help, or to notice their condition. And possibly even save their life. How great would that be? Cheese and sour cream. Oh, we've made it through a third of the day. Haven't screwed anything up too terribly. Oh, shit. Oh, this is gonna get really complicated. I didn't even think about that. Cheese, sour cream, and butter. Nothing on it. Everything? Ranch, cheese, everything on it. Thousand Island, cheese, bacon, greens and carrots, all that. Cheese, sour cream, butter, onion, sour cream and onion. One beer. Just greens and onions, or greens and carrots. Ranch, cheese, everything. Nothing on it. This is gonna ruin me. I swear, this guy who's making the bet with me is messing with my restaurant. Why else would he be making such crazy bets? I bet he's placing the rats outside. He's the one forgetting to flush in the bathroom. He's doing all kinds of malicious things to try to mess me up. And he's probably winning, or working. Being successful doing all this messing me up stuff. And he's probably also here ordering the most complicated things on the menu, just to try to mess with me again. Well, I did say I could have taken the salad off the menu. In hindsight, taking the baked potato off the menu would have been the thing to keep me safe. Because this thing can actually catch fire. Thousand Island cheese, bacon, onions, greens, and carrots. Sour cream, bacon, onions, cheese, sour cream, butter, sour cream, bacon, and onions. Cheese, onions, and peppers. That baked potato is seriously a Chekhov's gun. Cheese, sour cream, butter, and bacon. Is that a thing? Apparently. Sour cream, butter, bacon, and cheese? Ranch cheese, bacon croutons, onions, and peppers. Just greens and carrots. No bad orders. So I actually won the bet. I did make a couple lame dishes, but I made it. They've remodeled my restaurant about 5 days too late. In my opinion. It would have been cool to have the restaurant remodeled before now, but okay, I'll take it. New goals for me. It's a nice little hole in the wall, I guess. Welcome. They'll be more patient. Oh my goodness. Thank goodness. That I appreciate. New prep station. So I'll have you to search. Oh god. No! Okay. That's gonna suck. More about prep stations. Okay. I'm opening our pantry here at Iron Cook Kitchen for you to purchase brand new specialty foods. Chef Marinara. Gosh, what a dumb bet that was. I don't know. It's not waiting for HL3. You guys go enjoy this. I'm going to refill my water again. So it's funny, the game tells me the customers will be more patient, but at the same time, I'm gonna have extra customers to serve because I have an extra station. Which sucks, because I'm the only person operating. Please ignore this email if the game's already out right now and we're all in flying space cars. Yep, good to know. Wait, so I can upgrade my baked potato. Oh crap. It's not claiming that this is difficult though. New spices and olives upgrade. It's a $700 upgrade to charge $2 extra each time we'd served. I'd rather have this, honestly. This practically doubles the amount I make each time I serve a chicken. How excellent would that be? This practically doubles the amount I get each time I serve ice cream, too. This just seems like so much work. And yeah, customers never tip on it either. So what's in my menu today? We're gonna throw lasagna and chicken back in the mix. And, unless I want to upgrade or add some equipment, I think I'm just ready. Yeah, let's go. Begin. Yeah, first thing in the morning, ask for a beer. Somebody knows how to celebrate. Seriously, that one extra customer is just going to be that much more taxing. That bit much more taxing. Two chocolate scoops and sprinkles, cheese, sour cream, butter, bacon. And like, it's good to see that people appreciate my edible chicken. Just greens and carrots. Also, isn't it weird that the chores occupy an entire prep station? Yeah, it'd be awesome if I could get all of my dishes to be slow-cooked dishes that didn't require much effort. Oh shit. I think I'm gonna have a very unhappy customer on my hands there. Shit. Butter, chives, bacon. I don't so much mind the extra customer is a challenge enough, but the fact that I'm getting more chores too is kind of a problem. Shit. I might have to do something about our rat problem. Or I just might have to get better at this. Cheese, greens, and carrots. It's any wonder that the customers pay me when I mess up their dishes. Sour cream, bacon, onions. Shit. Whatever. I made $400 that day. Whew, that was exciting. Mysterious tickets. J. Walter Whitman III. His invention is one we all use today, which is, of course, the one everyone knows him for. Back then, it was simply chicken and the lantern. Chicken bones and lantern fluid. Today, we use synthesized chicken bones. I have no idea what this invention is. He never once married, as marriage to an animal was considered taboo back in the 1850s. Yeah. Can I upgrade? No, I cannot afford to upgrade my chicken dish. That's so ridiculous. It's so unfair. I just want 19 more bucks so I can make better chicken. I think I hit that 7 times instead of 6. Just gotta ask yourself one question. Do I feel lucky? Oh, I guess I'm lucky. But now I can afford the new chicken dish, so now my chicken can cost twice as much. Just greens and carrots. Okay. I effed up a dish. These guys are not forgiving at all with the pasta dish. Ranch and cheese. Or I'm sorry, not with the pasta, with the lasagna dish. They're not forgiving. Thank you. 1,000 customers served? Can that be right? Salad upgrade available. Lawsuit settled. Your judgment is below under the grounds you stay within 100 feet of a fire hydrant. Wait. What kind of lawsuit could this possibly be? People versus O'Hara. Well, I mean, am I on the side of the people or on the side of O'Hara? I assume I'm not on the side of the people, but I just don't get it. Because you can't countersue the people. Other than, like, negligence. Instead of learning how to make baskets and sell them, learn how to avoid the necessity of selling them in the first place. Wait. So is the point to just make baskets and never sell them? Or to never have to be able to make the basket such that you never have to sell it? I don't know. That's confusing. But! Now I can finally upgrade this dumb chicken dish. Yeah, we're gonna do it. Finally. That's gonna be fun. That was totally worth it. And I could have bought all this other useful and necessary stuff. Instead, opt to upgrade my chicken. My active menu. Well, my menu already suffers from menu rot. Yeah, I'm gonna take the baked potato off of there in favor of re-adding the cola machine. It's gonna be confusing as heck, but whatever. I feel just like that baked potato is a time bomb, in a sense. Just makes me nervous having it there. Large cola, no ice. See, a cola machine's not so confusing. In hindsight. Okay, so far so good. I still don't know if I can interrupt a dish to move to a different dish. I suspect no. Because there's no way to move back to it. I think I forgot to include ice. We didn't call for iced tea, he just called for tea with Flavor Blast. I want to say that they didn't do that on purpose. Ice cream upgrade available. So I can upgrade my upgrade. Perfect. 20 perfect order. Oh. Yeah, no, screw that. That makes no sense. I hate writing emails but love your food. No text. New catering job available is a thing I skipped through. Dude, I cannot afford to upgrade my salad. Oh, that would be cool though. Another dressing. Six new recipe cards. There's no way that would get confusing. Spices, olives, and four new recipes. Oh, wait. Before we do any of that, before I completely drive myself mad, I should take care of this thing. Rat pesticide. So tired of dealing with rats because that's just a distraction. No perfect day for me today, as I completely missed a customer. That's sad, but I mean, you'd think customers would be more understanding and that sort of thing. You would think. Also, does my air conditioner unit carry forward from the first place to this place? I would hope so, but probably not. In fairness to me, I do have a really challenging menu. And I don't have any fried foods on it, which is probably making this really super challenging for no reason. Is that like 3 failures today? 3 just abject failures? I think so. That's what I get for my mind wandering, trying to think of a conversation topic while I play. Thousand Island. Cheese, bacon, onions, greens. There we go. Failures, one average that I got at the end of the day because I was distracted. Baked potato, thank goodness. Safety inspection due. I can afford the baked potato upgrade, so let's go for it. That's gonna be fun. What's on my menu? I guess I have to take chicken off the menu eventually. Add the baked potato back in. And yeah, let's add the pretzel back in. It's a nice It's a nice alternation to my normal cooking stuff. Well, that was convenient. Cheese, onions, and peppers. Yep, that's right, Health Inspector. I serve drinks in the morning. What you gonna do, shut me down? You could have a drink if you want, you know. Also, how great would it be if we served things that people might be allergic to? Just how exciting might that make this? Onions and peppers, ranch and cheese, large cola, no ice, large diet with flavor blast, small tea with ice, brewski, small cola with ice and flavor blast. Thousand Island, cheese, everything on it. Cheese, greens, just salt. Okay, made it through rush number one. Didn't get killed. That's pretty cool. Just butter. Okay. Nothing on it. So what's with these people who order pretzels with nothing on them? Salt, butter. Cheese, sour cream, butter. Oh shit. That was not what that person ordered at all. I hope they enjoyed it. Because they obviously didn't. Cheese, sour cream, butter, bacon, onions, spices. Cheese, sour cream, butter, olives, and spices. Ranch, cheese, croutons, peppers. Sour cream, butter and bacon, butter, chives and onions, large diet, mac and cheese, nothing on it, cheese, sour cream, butter, spices. Butter, chives, bacon. One beer. Ranch, cheese, onions and peppers. Yeah, you'd think I'd be able to manage some of the chores, like dishes. Is there any way I can manage those while they're building up? Alright, so I think I flubbed about, what, 4 or 5? Okay, completely failed one. I'm not even sure which one. No, it was the salad thing that I goofed up. Nachos upgrade available. New catering job available. Inspection passed. Yep, there's nothing I can upgrade for 400. And nothing worth buying for 400 that I'm able to prepare. There's nachos. That's kind of a mess, isn't it? Okay, active menu. Well, it keeps telling me about this menu rot thing. Although, that seems not to be a thing right here. For variety's sake, so I don't lose my mind, I'm gonna put some things back on the menu. And we'll go. Well, it's a quiet morning. Way to take my inputs. I move just the slightest bit, and it doesn't want my inputs anymore. Wrong button. I'm trying to jam out to my music here, and $8 tip? Seriously? Why would you tip $8 for anything you get here? Unless you really believe that much in my establishment. Or perhaps your judgment's just that impaired. I don't know. Also, what's up with people who get pretzels and don't get cinnamon? Like, isn't cinnamon one of the better spices you could put on a pretzel? Why would you avoid it? Actually, cinnamon and sugar is kind of interesting, too. Also, why? Just why would you get a plain pretzel? At that point, just get nice warm bread. There's no need to get a pretzel. And put nothing on it. When you could just get nice bread and, like, add butter or any kind of spread to it. Or a bagel. Or any other kind of thing of that nature. I just don't understand. But I guess everybody has their own preferences, and we can't argue about that. We can just point out when they're wrong. Nice. Not too shabby. Starting to get the hang of this. Lasagna upgrade available. I don't have any fried food on my menu. See, a new trend that all the teens are doing, and that's something I'm called the Pepper Jack. I'm not entirely sure what it involves, but all I know is my kid was talking nonsense when I got home, and there's a pepper grinder, a block of cheese, and a radish out. You don't even want to know. Don't want to know. Alright. So I could upgrade my lasagna thing to make it even more confusing. Or I could go with the baked potato. Vegetable lasagna. New vegetable layer and a recipe card. Let's see. What's the progression here? 8 to 12, 12 to 15, 15 to 20. But let's take a look at our baked potato. It's certain to cause me a headache. Also, what's this? Our salad. Yeah, so I guess the lasagna is probably a good return on investment. Also, I keep forgetting to do... there's some catering things. I keep forgetting that I've got this stuff out here. Drinks aplenty. Beer and soda. That's it? Well, that sounds fun. Let's do it. I think my employees were depressed during a refreshment party. With no more than 3 bad orders. Okay. This might be tricky. Oh, did my game crash? That would make it more challenging for sure. Well, that was fun. Oh, no, here we go. One beer, please. Small diet with ice. Oh shit. Nice! Catering successful. I'll take it. So, this gives me some money to upgrade stuff. Six new recipe cards. $14.80. What's the best use of $14.80? I mean, that seems manageable. Oh, this is the final upgrade that's known for the salad. I was gonna say that's possible, but there might be more. $7.50 to upgrade this. $600 to upgrade lasagna. Yeah, I should actually upgrade this already. What's been holding me back? Customers never tip. Not ordered during rush hours. Well, yeah, I'm gonna upgrade my lasagna. I think I want to upgrade the baked potato also. Let's give this a go. Start new day. Begin! Okay, that wasn't so hard. Medium cola, no ice. Pasta, sauce, veggies, cheese, parmesan. Cheesy and broccoli. Sour cream and onions. Small water with ice. Small grape with ice. Well, not even reading it. Hopefully they'll be okay with what I served. Nice, I got it right. I guess that game has trained me after all to not mess up too badly. You can definitely hear the music jiving in the background. It's funny how the guy's shirt, I don't know, doesn't quite match up with his body. You can see some art, some effort was made to make it artistic, but not enough. Sour cream, chives, onions. Cheese, sour cream, butter, bacon. Fuck. These people should just be used to the fact that I'm gonna mess up their dishes. I just have too many complicated things on the menu and there's too many people arriving during rush hour. And really, and despite having all these extra services to take care of rats and trash and dishes and all this stuff, it's just not enough. Another chicken upgrade is available. Nice. I was on the news. They were talking about some special report on the news when a crazy naked person went running around the tower. And they had your restaurant in the background. Hooray! Okay, I'll take it. Silver ticket. Noodle sticks. You know, that was a real jerk move last night. Should have known better than that. Should have asked you if you were allergic to dairy products beforehand. Okay, I get it. Haha, very funny. And immature. Man, this would be a nice thing to add to my menu. Too bad it's not happening anytime soon. But yeah. Potentially I could add a burger. Why haven't I added this to my menu yet? This would have been an awesome thing to have. I just haven't been thinking about it. It's not even that hard to make and everybody likes it. So, what's the deal? Trashy food, fat, menu rot. Yes, I'd have to rotate it with my other items, but a burger would make a lot of sense on my menu. Pasta might make sense. It requires a stove, though. A burger can be done on a grill, such as the grill I have. Fresh fish would be a great thing. Yeah, no, I should make my way toward getting a burger soon. French fries and sopapillas to be able to do fried foods. So what's driving people away at the moment? The lasagna and the chicken. They've just had too much lasagna and too much chicken. Incredible. Truly incredible. How could they ever have too much lasagna? But I guess the game wants me to try to keep this an interesting experience. So we'll do that. Shuffle it up and approach a new day. Nothing on it. Yeah, you just keep on walking, buddy. I know you're up to something if you want a pretzel with nothing on it. Mushrooms, tomatoes, greens, and carrots. Cheese, sour cream, butter, chives, bacon, and onions. You just know people are going to order all this really complex baked potato stuff during rush hour when I have no time to read what it is they want. Ranch cheese, bacon, onions and peppers, small grape with ice, ranch and cheese, bacon and croutons, butter, chives, bacon, ranch, cheese, onions and peppers, butter, chives and bacon. Cheese and sour cream. Oh, I should not have started those both at exactly the same time, because that's doom. Oh, just butter. Okay, I can do that. I can do cheese and sour cream. But yeah, starting those at exactly the same time was not a bright move on my part. Sour cream, chives, onions. Just butter. Well, we got 25 in a row. That's not too shabby. Cheese, sour cream, butter, all this stuff in the left column. Just butter. Rush hour 2 incoming! 2 chocolate sprinkles. You know, one day I'll learn to do the dishes before rush hour. As opposed to waiting until the middle of it to do all my errands. I guess there's only so much you can do, but still. cheese, sour cream, chives, onions, spices, broccoli, peppers. Cheese, onion, greens and carrots. Just greens and carrots. Thousand Island, cheese, bacon, croutons, onions and peppers, greens and carrots. Well, I failed that pretty epically, for those who are watching. Which, I'm pretty sure it's not too many people at this point. How many minutes of this game can people watch before... I mean, the music's relaxing. The gameplay, not so much. Especially when you can't remember, on this style of controller, which button's the Y button. Cheese, sour cream, chives, onions, spices, and broccoli. It's the wrong thing for broccoli. Jumbo cola with ice and flavor blast. Well, I only completely effed up three dishes. Overall, I think my focus is starting to not be so focused. So let's see, did any events happen after the day ends? No. Completed 9 out of 20 days of service. Passed a safety inspection. Done a catering. However, much more remains to be done to progress in this game. I still want to unlock more recipes. And maybe find a way, like, is there more equipment available? What have I completely missed here? I think it's just that I'm missing simple recipes. And I got all these cool upgrades and stuff, but I've skimped on the obvious stuff. Such as just having simple recipes that aren't a total pain in the butt to make. Because you look at this menu and you see, like, tons and tons of stars. And I've gone out of my way to avoid fatty foods if I can. But this is America. And so I need to put on less healthy items onto this menu if I want to have any chance of succeeding in a day. Without completely tanking on any one of the recipes. Anyhow, that was fun. It's a bit exhausting, so I guess I'm going to break, and we'll pick this up next time. In the meantime, maybe do some chess or something else, but yeah, have fun, and just cook, serve, delicious. I'm trying to make some pun, but nothing comes to mind, so just have a good night.